Joining me now is Royal and Entertainment reporter Kinsey Schofield. Kinsey, last week we spoke on this program about Amal Clooney's involvement in the ICC, the International Criminal Court, and she wrote on the Clooney Foundation website, "We unanimously conclude that there are reasonable grounds to believe that the Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and Israeli Defence Minister Yoav Gallant have committed war crimes and crimes against humanity, including starvation as a method of warfare, murder, persecution and extermination. I served on this panel because I believe in the rule of law and the need to protect civilian lives." But her position on the panel is interesting, well, for a number of reasons, including that one of her relatives is reportedly the corrupt businessman Ziad Takieddine, who was a middleman for arms deals between France and a number of Muslim countries in the Middle East. What do we know about this relationship, and what has been the feedback to Amal Clooney's involvement in the ICC?
Well, we've discovered the link when her uncle had to ask the court system permission to go celebrate their wedding, their nuptials. So that's actually how we found out that that she was related to this arms dealer. I mean, I think the general reaction to this is clean up your own front porch. George and Amal Clooney not only quietly created it, but they donated $500,000 to Washington's march against gun violence in 2018. You know, he recently ticked off Alec Baldwin by calling the Rust shooting infuriating. Campaigning against weapons lacks credibility when your uncle has a Glock vending machine in his master bath.
Well, yeah, and it's quite difficult to find out information about this uncle and the links with Amal. There's been allegations that a fair bit of work has been done to clean up some of the commentary that's online about that relationship. But let's talk about singer and actress Kelly Rowland. She was in the spotlight this week for a confrontation on the red carpet between her and an attendant at the Cannes Film Festival. A lip reader on TikTok has suggested this is what happened.
"Don't talk to me like that. Don't talk to me like that. No, don't talk to me like that. You are not my mother, and you don't talk to me like that. I'm not a child. Don't talk to me like that."
After that incident, Kelly Rowland alleged that she was, well, she seemed to allege that she was a victim of racism.
"And there were other women that attended that carpet who did not quite look like me. And they didn't get there, scolded or pushed off or told to get off."
Kinsey, new footage has emerged of Dominican actress Maciel Taveras being moved on by this same security guard, it looks like, who was involved in the Kelly Rowland incident. Another argument has again got heated. Does this confirm what Kelly Rowland was alleging there, that she was being treated differently to the other famous folk walking the red carpet?
I mean, I think you're being very generous with the word famous. I've never seen the lady in the Jesus dress, and what would Jesus do? Not throw somebody else down a flight of stairs. But I, you know, it certainly, it contradicts what Kelly said. It sounds like everybody was trying to stretch out their 15 minutes in front of the photogs, and these people have been instructed to move them along. And if that guard had handled that inappropriately, according to her employers, we wouldn't have seen her there for another interaction. Somebody is clearly telling her, just move these egomaniacs along. Get them in. We've got a showing. We've got a premiere. Get them through the door.
Well, there's more footage of an Asian actress, again, someone I don't know, who had the same treatment, was being moved along. But I guess if you're saying this is racist, you'd go, they're all ethnic minorities that this has happened to. It's not a blonde actress. But I think you're right. Perhaps because there are just so many going through the red carpet, they've just got minimal time in that prime position, and they've just got to keep walking. And I guess Kelly Rowland would be thinking, I'm a big star compared to the Dominican lass whose name we've already forgotten. So I think she was surprised probably because she expected to be able to take her time on the red carpet. Now, let's talk about South Park. They've lambasted the celebrity Ozempic craze in the latest episode, The End of Obesity. And for the characters who want the weight loss drug but can't afford it, there's a new drug, according to South Park. It's called Lizzo for body positivity. And Lizzo herself took to Instagram to blind react to her name drop in this episode. Have a look.
Which of the drugs are you on, Sharon? Ozempic, Mounjaro?
Oh, no, I talked to my doctor. He said insurance would only pay for those if I had diabetes.
But if you can't afford them, then how are you managing your weight?
Don't you know, Sheila? Now there's a whole new obesity drug for those of us who can't afford Ozempic and Mounjaro. I've controlled all my cravings to be thinner with Lizzo.
It's Lizzo.
FDA-approved Lizzo makes you feel good about your weight, and it costs 90% less than Ozempic.
I've lowered my standards and my expectations.
It's Lizzo.
In case studies, 70% of patients on Lizzo no longer cared how much they weighed.
I don't give two s***s.
Oh, I love South Park, you know that. And I think Lizzo there did the right thing. She didn't seem to be too precious about it. She had a moment afterwards of saying that, you know, she's proud of the role she's played in saying just love yourself the way you are. So I don't know. People are saying this is a cope, as the kids say, but I think she's handled it as well as you could handle that.
Yeah, I think publicly she did the right thing and you know, made fun of herself a little bit and was like, I am that girl. But I also think that there were some pretty cutting remarks there, and she probably is hurt behind the scenes because she's had a hard year. We have gone over some of the allegations and some of the things she's been accused of over the last 12 months or more. So I think that she is struggling when it comes to her personal brand.
Yes, but well, there's a few things she's done that really set her up for criticism. It's almost like she's inviting mockery and criticism. We've played some of that footage on this program. Now let's talk about this new portrait of Princess Kate. There was that controversial portrait of King Charles. I was one of the few people who actually liked it. But this one, I've got to say, is a shocker. It was commissioned by posh high society magazine Tatler. It looks nothing like her. It looks pretty much a striking resemblance, I would say, to Gina Carano. If we get a picture of Gina up, we can see they look the same, but it doesn't look like Kate. Kinsey, I think I could do a better job than that.
Oh, I'm sure you could. That is stank face. It looks like President Joe Biden crop dusted poor Kate at COP26 like he did poor Camilla. Queen Camilla. That is not a very flattering facial expression. And that is all I could think of was the COP26 story about Joe Biden, you know, passing gas in front of the Queen consort.
That is, oh gosh. Yeah. Please tell me that is just some sort of an urban myth. That didn't really happen, no. Surely. The woman's a
it
queen.
Happened.
You cannot.
It happened.
Jeez. My gosh. Before you go, Kinsey, staying in Britain, stand-up comic, alleged comic Nish Kumar, has pulled out of the Hay Book Festival, joining a growing number of writers who've boycotted the event over its sponsorship by investment management firm Baillie Gifford, which has ties to Israel. This firm has now been dropped as a sponsor. The festival is caved into the anti-Israeli activists. This is a massive issue in the world of entertainment right now, isn't it?
It is. You know, and what I would say is his loss. I wouldn't know this guy if he dropped off my Domino's pizza. But yeah, this is a huge issue. So, who is he? So, I mean, you know, this is a really disappointing, I think the results are absolutely disappointing.
Absolutely. They're just caving into the hate mob. They're sending entirely the wrong message. Kinsey Schofield, thank you so much for your time.